Yes, yes, Christ's clarity leads to salvation. Spirituality continues your fixation with existence, which is damnation. It's a negation, constant negating, a dynamic of negating. There's nothing wrong with trying to be spiritual, just so long as you realize it has absolutely nothing to do with your salvation. If you feel like trying to make the world a better place, trying to be a better person, more loving, more affectionate, doing good things for your fellow humans and for the earth and all that, go ahead and do that. But just be very clear that it has nothing to do with your salvation. Everything you do constructive will be swept away by destructivity. Just so long as you know that. If that's what you want to do, continue doing that, then go ahead. It doesn't cause reality any problems. But of course, be very clear, purpose of existence is negation. You cannot negate a void, so all constructivity is just the puppet, the plaything of destructivity. It arises so that it can be destroyed. So everything that you build up will be torn down. That is the dance of existence. That is the nature of existence. It cannot be changed. You cannot change effects. You can only change ideas. You can only change cause. When you change cause, then the effects are in alignment with that cause. Every idea has its own effects. So Christ's clarity is the way to salvation. Seeing this is the way to salvation. So really you choose between spirituality or salvation. That is the true choice that you are faced with. And if you can see that, then you're in a very good position indeed. And it's likely that 100% of your friends and your contacts and your teachers are all about spirituality. And you think, oh my gosh, the peer pressure. It's so strong. I can't do it. Well, okay, see that. See that. See, it's peer pressure. The pressure in this world is overwhelming to choose spirituality as so-called the highest good, the highest path, the greatest aspiration, the greatest goal we're capable of, when in fact it's exactly the thing we have to let go of and instead choose Christ's clarity. So there's so much pressure. That's why I'm speaking up, to just give you a little helping hand to realize if you choose Christ's clarity, you're not entirely alone. That's important. And as far as what kind of person you are, forget about it. Doesn't matter. As soon as you choose Christ's clarity, you'll begin to focus on what's really important. And you'll become a committed, focused person. Whatever your personality functions like, that will be secondary to your sense of true purpose and your growing clarity. And that will give more momentum to your path, to your real path towards Christ's clarity, and you will begin to transcend all the accoutrements of spirituality. You'll have a different perspective on it. You won't be bound by it. You'll be escaping the grasp of the goddess. She's got her fingernails dug into you, deep. Her talons are really deep, but gradually you're relaxing their grasp bit by bit by bit, and she'll throw all her camp followers at you with their tambourines and their beautiful dances and saying, oh, stay with us, stay with us, the siren song of spirituality, saying, how can you leave us? We're so beautiful, we're so sensitive, we're so kind, we're so affectionate, we're so loving, and on and on and on. And you'll just say, no, I don't think so. I think I'm going to go and choose a new idea instead. And that's wisdom right there. That's what you're looking for. That's Christ's clarity. And she and her camp followers will say, but there is nothing else. Nobody wants to escape us. And you say, no, that's not true. I'm listening to something right now, Christ's Clarity channel here on YouTube. And I'm hearing very clearly that it's very easy to actually dismiss, brush aside the inducements of spirituality. You don't want to be a spiritual person. You want to be a free spirit. But you are a spirit. You're free to choose new ideas. That's how you were created. That's what you are and always will be. Being a spiritual person is the ultimate booby prize. Forget about it. And notice we're not saying be a free person. We're saying being a free spirit. Not a free-spirited person, but a true free spirit, a spirit that is free of this idea of trying to replace reality with a new reality, a spirit that has been freed by choosing a new idea. There's no such thing as spirit not experiencing an idea. Spirit is always experiencing an idea. No such thing as spirit in a void experiencing no idea. No. Spirit's always experiencing an idea. So, if spirit doesn't like one idea, what does spirit do? It chooses a new idea. Very simple. That's how spirit functions. So a spirit that is free is a spirit that has chosen an idea other than the idea of trying to replace reality. Because this idea is an idea which insists that spirit is bound to this one idea to the complete exclusion of all other ideas. And so there's no freedom, sense of freedom in this idea at all. It's a sense of imprisonment. And in that imprisonment, the goddess comes and says, oh, how fortunate you are. You can now become a spiritualized person, a spiritual human being, as if that's some great thing, you know. Oh, congratulations, you're in jail for all eternity, but you can wear some linen clothes and do some chanting. Isn't that nice? Wonderful. You say, thanks, but no thanks. You can just say, I'm all spiritualized out. No thanks. And get on with Christ's clarity, which clarifies that choosing a new idea is your right, your authority, your capacity. Right now, in every single moment, you are not bound by any idea from moment to moment to moment, including the one you're experiencing right now, which is the idea of trying to replace reality with a new reality. You're not bound to that, even though this idea makes its purpose the insistence that you are bound to it, either by some kind of technical necessity or by fear that all other ideas have been dissipated and destroyed and gone, so you don't have any choice. You have no choice but to be bound by it. But that's a lie. That's a mistaken belief. It's part of the defense system that's spun around this idea, which keeps you fixated on it. But what we're doing, Christ's clarity, softens the fixation, loosens the fixation, relaxes the fixation on existence through clarification. You don't have to do anything with your body, the human body. You don't need to do anything at all with that. You don't need to tighten it up, tense it up, relax it, nothing. Just be as you are, wherever you are. Just turn to clarity, clarification. The clarity is there within you. Because you haven't been destroyed. You haven't been replaced. You are not a human person. You're a spirit trying to become a human person and believing in that. But that doesn't change what you are. Reality is not affected by dreams of its demise. Not in the slightest bit. Even reality cannot destroy reality. Okay? Reality is inviolate. You cannot harm it. You cannot corrupt it. You cannot replace it. It is what it is, and always will be. And you don't need to prove anything first. As a human person, you don't need to prove your spirituality. Nobody's waiting. Reality's not waiting for you to prove anything. What do you need to prove reality in order for reality to be real and functional? Nothing at all. It was real and functional from the very beginning. Doesn't need to have anything added to it, and nothing can be subtracted to it. So there's no need to wait another moment to choose a new idea. That's the focus, that's the purpose of Christ's clarity, which is replacing, it's in exchange for your spirituality, all your passive spirituality. At some point, you'll get very tired of those and realize it was a wild goose chase. Got you nowhere. Except pumped up your vanity, your spiritual vanity, and your pride and your ego. Like, oh, what a wonderful person I am that I can be so kind and affectionate. Meanwhile, you're not sharing any truth with anyone. You're reinforcing everyone that they're human persons, which is not true at all. Human persons are just constructs that the mind has imagined up, constructs to be negated as proof that there's some power of negation capable of negating and replacing reality. It's all manufactured evidence, so you're just going nowhere when that's your focus, when your focus is on people, on persons. It doesn't matter whether your focus is, well, on being a good person and saying that other people are good people, or a bad person saying people are bad. Doesn't matter. Either way, it makes no difference. You can any moment turn to Christ's clarity and refocus and realize, aha, this is the right focus to salvation. This is what I want, because this is leading me back to true functionality, which is choosing new ideas and experiencing those, and choosing ideas that do not exclude any other ideas. So you're aware of the boundlessness and your capabilities of experiencing, and the boundlessness of your freedom to choose at any moment any idea. That's the natural feeling that spirit has of bliss, the boundlessness, of endlessness, of seamlessness. That's what Christ's clarity is leading you to. Okay, that's it.